In 550 BC, Rome was the second largest city in Italy, with Tarentum being the largest. It had an area of about 285 hectares and an estimated population of 35,000. Other sources suggest the population was just under 100,000 from 600 to 500 BC. When the Republic was founded in 509 BC, the census recorded a population of 130,000. The Republic included the city itself and the immediate surroundings. Other sources suggest a population of 150,000 in 500 BC. The size of the city at the time of the Emperor Augustus is a matter of speculation, with estimates based on grain distribution, grain imports, aqueduct capacity, city limits, population density, census reports, and assumptions about the number of unreported women, children and slaves providing a very wide range. Glenn Story estimates 450,000 people, Whitney Oates estimates 1.2 million, Neville Morelli provides a rough estimate of 800,000 and excludes earlier suggestions of 2 million. Estimates of the city's population vary.
A. H. M. Jones estimated the population at 650,000 in the mid-5th century.
The population had already started to decline from the late 4th century onward, although around the middle of the 5th century it seems that Rome continued to be the most populous city of the two parts of the empire. After the Gothic Wars, 535 to 552, the population may have dwindled temporarily to 30,000. Neil Christie, citing free rations for the poorest, estimated 500,000 in the mid-5th century and still a quarter of a million at the end of the century. This has been used to suggest a population of just under 500,000. The city's population declined to less than 50,000 people in the Dark Ages from 700 AD onward. When the Kingdom of Italy annexed Rome in 1870, the city had a population of about 225,000. Less than half the city within the walls was built up in 1881 when the population recorded was 275,000. In mid-2010, there were 2,754,440 residents in the city proper, while some 4.2 million people lived in the Greater Rome area. Minors totaled 17.00% of the population compared to pensioners who numbered 20.76%. This compares with the Italian average of 18.06% and 19.94%. In the 5 years between 2002 and 2007, the population of Rome grew by 6.54%, while Italy as a whole grew by 3.56%. The current birth rate of Rome is 9.10 births per 1,000 inhabitants compared to the Italian average of 9.45 births. The urban area of Rome extends beyond the administrative city limits with a population of around 3.9 million. Between 3.2 and 4.2 million people live in the Rome metropolitan area. According to the latest statistics conducted by Istat, approximately 9.5% of the population consists of non-Italians. About half of the immigrant population consists of those of various other European origins, numbering a combined total of 131,118 or 4.7% of the population. The remaining 4.8% are those with non-European origins, chiefly Filipinos, Bangladeshis, and Chinese. The Esquilino Rione, off-termini railway station, has evolved into a largely immigrant neighborhood. It is perceived as Rome's Chinatown. Immigrants from more than 100 different countries reside there. A commercial district, Esquilino contains restaurants featuring many kinds of international cuisine. There are wholesale clothes shops. Of the 1,300 or so commercial premises operating in the district, 800 are Chinese-owned, around 300 are run by immigrants from other countries around the world, 200 are owned by Italians. Much like the rest of Italy, Rome is predominantly Christian, and the city has been an important center of religion and pilgrimage for centuries, the base of the ancient Roman religion with the Pontifex Maximus and later the seat of the Vatican and the Pope. Before the arrival of the Christians in Rome, the Religio Romana was the major religion of the city in classical antiquity. The first gods held sacred by the Romans were Jupiter, the Most High, and Mars, god of war, and father of Rome's twin founders, Romulus and Remus, according to tradition. Other deities such as Vesta and Minerva were honored. Rome was also the base of several mystery cults, such as Mithraism. Later, after Saint Peter and Saint Paul were martyred in the city, and the first Christians began to arrive, Rome became Christian, and the old Saint Peter's Basilica was constructed in 313 AD. Despite some interruptions, Rome has for centuries been the home of the Roman Catholic Church and the Bishop of Rome, otherwise known as the Pope. Despite the fact that Rome is home to the Vatican City and St. Peter's Basilica, Rome's cathedral is the Archbasilica of St. John Lateran, in the southeast of the city center. There are around 900 churches in Rome in total. Aside from the cathedral itself, some others of note include the Basilica di Santa Maria Maggiore, the Basilica of St. Paul outside the walls, the Basilica di San Clemente, San Carlo alla Quattro Fontane, and the Church of the Gesù. There are also the ancient catacombs of Rome underneath the city. Numerous highly important religious educational institutions are also in Rome, such as the Pontifical Lateran University, Pontifical Biblical Institute, Pontifical Gregorian University, and Pontifical Oriental Institute. In recent years, there has been growth in Rome's Muslim community, mainly due to immigration from North Africa and the Middle East into the city. As a result of this increase of the local practitioners of the Islamic faith, the Comune promoted the building of the Mosque of Rome, which is the largest mosque in Western Europe, designed by architect Paolo Portoghesi and inaugurated on June 21, 1995. Since the end of the Roman Republic, Rome is also the center of an important Jewish community, which was once based in Trastevere, and later in the Roman ghetto. There lies also the major synagogue in Rome, the Tempio Maggiore. The territory of Vatican City is part of the Mons Vaticanus, and of the adjacent former Vatican fields, where St. Peter's Basilica, the Apostolic Palace, the Sistine Chapel, and museums were built, along with various other buildings. The area was part of the Roman Rione of Borgo until 1929. Being separated from the city on the west bank of the Tiber, the area was a suburb that was protected by being included within the walls of Leo IV, later expanded by the current fortification walls of Paul III, Pius IV, and Urban VIII. When the Lateran Treaty of 1929 that created the Vatican State was being prepared, the boundaries of the proposed territory were influenced by the fact that much of it was all but enclosed by this loop. For some parts of the border there was no wall, but the line of certain buildings supplied part of the boundary, and for a small part a new wall was constructed. The territory includes St. Peter's Square, separated from the territory of Italy only by a white line along the limit of the square, where it borders Piazza Pio XII. St. Peter's Square is reached through the Via della Conciliazione, which runs from the Tiber to St. Peter's. This grand approach was designed by architects Piacentini and Spaccarelli, on the instructions of Benito Mussolini and in accordance with the Church, after the conclusion of the Lateran Treaty. According to the treaty, certain properties of the Holy See located in Italian territory, most notably the Papal Palace of Castel Gandolfo and the major basilicas, enjoy extraterritorial status similar to that of foreign embassies. Rome has been a major Christian pilgrimage site since the Middle Ages. People from all over the Christian world visit Vatican City, within the city of Rome, the seat of the papacy. The city became a major pilgrimage site during the Middle Ages. Apart from brief periods as an independent city during the Middle Ages, Rome kept its status as papal capital and holy city for centuries, even when the papacy briefly relocated to Avignon. Catholics believe that the Vatican is the last resting place of St. Peter. Pilgrimages to Rome can involve visits to many sites, both within Vatican City and in Italian territory. A popular stopping point is the Pilate Stairs. These are, according to the Christian tradition, the steps that led up to the Praetorium of Pontius Pilate in Jerusalem, which Jesus Christ stood on during his passion on his way to trial. The stairs were, reputedly, brought to Rome by Helena of Constantinople in the 4th century. For centuries, the Scala Santa has attracted Christian pilgrims who wish to honor the Passion of Jesus. Other objects of pilgrimage include several catacombs built in imperial times, in which Christians prayed, buried their dead and performed worship during periods of persecution, and various national churches, or churches associated with individual religious orders, such as the Jesuit Churches of Jesus and Sant'Apostrofe Ignazio. Traditionally, pilgrims in Rome visit the seven pilgrim churches in 24 hours. This custom, mandatory for each pilgrim in the Middle Ages, was codified in the 16th century by St. Philip Neri. The seven churches are the four major basilicas, while the other three are San Lorenzo fuori la Mura, Santa Croce in Gerusalemme, and San Sebastiano fuori la Mura.